Breaking: Hawaii on lockdown after North Korea fired devastating ballistic missile. After months of threats and tests, North Korea's despot dictator, Kim Jong-un, flexed his muscles and launched an intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBM, this morning. The little rocket man likely chuckled to himself, basking in the glow as he envisioned the explosion of what ended up being his target. Now, for the first time since the end of the Cold War, Hawaii has just something that indicates the threat of World War III could be a reality, as other world leaders warn of the same thing. This is North Korea's latest provocation of war that could be their last after two missiles flew directly over Japanese territory, terrifying citizens and sparking a round of worldwide condemnations and sanctions, according to Express. The Japanese government has issued an urgent warning that the final blow could be coming within the next few days. Hawaii has been under direct threat and they aren't taking any chances after seeing that Jong-un is not willing to stop until President Donald Trump personally makes him, which looks like will be sooner, rather than later. Fox News reports. North Korea fired an unidentified ballistic missile in the middle of the night local time Wednesday, a U.S. official confirmed to Fox News. South Korea's Yonhap News Agency, which first reported the launch, said the missile flew eastward from the vicinity of Pyongyang toward the Sea of Japan, according to South Korean military officials. The missile launch happened around 3 a.m. in North Korea. South Korea's military has reportedly staged a precision strike missile exercise in response. Japan's Prime Minister's Office for Disaster and Crisis Management Information tweeted shortly after the report, North Korea launched a missile that has the possibility of arriving in the exclusive economic zone, EZ, of our country, according to a translation. There have been signs indicating Kim Jong-un's regime was planning a missile launch in recent days. Japan's Kyodo News reported Monday the Japanese government detected radio signals pointing to a possible missile test in the near future. It was only a matter of time before North Korea tried this since Kim Jong-un has been strangely silent for a few months since his last launch in late July. There's no mistaking that what the dictator did was an act of war against Japan, and now it's time for him to pay the price for his actions. Today's launch comes only hours after Hawaii resumed Cold War-era nuclear siren tests after getting word of a pending threat from North Korea. After months of threats and tests, North Korea's despot dictator, Kim Jong-un, flexed his muscles and launched an intercontinental ballistic missile, ICBM, this morning. The little rocket man likely chuckled to himself, basking in the glow as he envisioned the explosion of what ended up being his target. Now, for the first time since the end of the Cold War, Hawaii has just something that indicates the threat of World War III could be a reality, as other world leaders warn of the same thing. This is North Korea's latest provocation of war that could be their last after two missiles flew directly over Japanese territory, terrifying citizens and sparking a round of worldwide condemnations and sanctions, according to Express. The Japanese government has issued an urgent warning that the final blow could be coming within the next few days. Hawaii has been under direct threat and they aren't taking any chances after seeing that Jong-un is not willing to stop until President Donald Trump personally makes him, which looks like will be sooner, rather than later. Fox News reports. North Korea fired an unidentified ballistic missile in the middle of the night local time Wednesday, a U.S. official confirmed to Fox News. South Korea's Yonhap News Agency, which first reported the launch, said the missile flew eastward from the vicinity of Pyongyang toward the Sea of Japan, according to South Korean military officials. The missile launch happened around 3 a.m. in North Korea. South Korea's military has reportedly staged a precision strike missile exercise in response. Japan's Prime Minister's Office for Disaster and Crisis Management Information tweeted shortly after the report, North Korea launched a missile that has the possibility of arriving in the exclusive economic zone, EZ, of our country, according to a translation. There have been signs indicating Kim Jong-un's regime was planning a missile launch in recent days. Japan's Kyodo News reported Monday the Japanese government detected radio signals pointing to a possible missile test in the near future. It was only a matter of time before North Korea tried this, since Kim Jong-un has been strangely silent for a few months since his last launch in late July. There's no mistaking that what the dictator did was an act of war against Japan, and now it's time for him to pay the price for his actions. Today's launch comes only hours after Hawaii resumed Cold War-era nuclear siren tests after getting word of a pending threat from North Korea. According to Reuters, wailing air raid sirens will be sounded for about 60 seconds from more than 400 locations across the Central Pacific Islands starting at 11:45 a.m. on Friday, in a test that will be repeated on the first business day of each month thereafter, state officials said. Monthly tests of the nuclear attack siren are being reintroduced in Hawaii in conjunction with public service announcements urging residents of the islands to get inside, stay inside, and stay tuned if they should hear the warning. Emergency preparedness is knowing what to expect and what to do for all hazards, Hawaii Emergency Management Agency Chief Vern Miyagi said in one video message posted online. He did not mention North Korea specifically. But the nuclear attack sirens, discontinued since the 1980s when the Cold War drew to a close, are being reactivated in light of recent test launches of intercontinental ballistic missiles from North Korea deemed capable of reaching the state, agency spokeswoman Arlena Agbayani told Reuters. A single 150-kiloton weapon detonated over Pearl Harbor on the main island of Oahu would be expected to kill 18,000 people outright and leave 50,000 to 120,000 others injured across a blast zone several miles wide, agency spokesman Richard Raposa said, citing projections based on assessments of North Korea's nuclear weapons technology. While casualties on that scale would be unprecedented on U.S. soil, a fact sheet issued by the agency stressed that 90% of Hawaii's 1.4 million plus residents would survive the direct effects of such an explosion. Oahu, home to a heavy concentration of the U.S. military command structure, as well as the state capital, Honolulu, and about two-thirds of the state's population, is seen as an especially likely target for potential North Korean nuclear aggression against the United States. Japan can only take so much and have appeared to have reached that threshold. For how small Kim Jong-un is, he's sure making a huge mistake by playing big boy games. He doesn't want to get into a war with America since we have the best army in the world and could obliterate his country from the planet in a matter of seconds. U.S. Secretary of Defense Jim Mattis stressed that the U.S. is trying to exhaust all diplomatic and economic options to end North Korea's missile program, however, those efforts are wearing out quickly with the persistence of refusal to cooperate from North Korea's leader. It can be difficult to tell when the diplomatic options have been exhausted because your enemy might be sneaky, or duplicitous in some way, and it's the responsibility of a country has to try and determine fact from fiction. That's not the case with North Korea, who has been clear about their intentions by coming right out in the open and announcing their plans for a fight.